Welcome to another episode of Dodgy Recruiter Tactics, the series where I break down the tips, tricks, tools, and downright disgusting things that recruiters do in their pursuit of making a quick buck. Now, as always, I will say that not all recruiters are bad. The vast majority of recruiters are bad, but the industry attracts people who are not in it to add value or to help, but are in it to make money. And that's a shame, but we just need to be aware of it when we're dealing with them. Recruiters will do pretty much anything to get the deal across the line because, like humans, they're incentivized and they're heavily incentivized with money, tens of thousands of dollars, if they manage to fill a role. So they do just about anything to do that, including the subject of today's video, lying. Specifically, lying about the marketplace. Now, I say marketplace, it sounds a bit wanky. It's a catch-all term for the industry they're recruiting in, and a lot of recruiters will specialize. I might be a digital recruiter, or a tech recruiter, or an accounting recruiter, or whatever. And they do that to specialize so they can understand more about the industry, but also to set themselves up as experts about what's happening in terms of hiring, recruitment, and growth and companies within those industries. Good recruiters will happily provide value, comments, guides on what's happening in the industry, what's hot, what's not, what's new, what companies are growing, what companies are shrinking, or anything like that. Good recruiters will happily share that information because they know it adds value and it helps you make an informed decision. And if they can help you do that, they will probably end up helping you get to another job, which is good for them. But dodgy recruiters don't think this way. Dodgy recruiters like to hoard information and only dole it out as they see fit and as they think it's important, and only when they see it benefiting them. And the ultimate benefit to them is filling a role where they will get paid their commission. They'll tell you the industry is hot when the industry's cold, or they will tell you it's cold when it's hot, or vice versa. In fact, I was going to insert a funny joke about temperatures here, but I couldn't be bothered. Like everything a recruiter does, it's important to go, why? Why would they bother lying? And it's obvious, it's to make money. Most recruiters are incentivized with a lot of money to place people into roles. And so the people who focus on that will do whatever behaviors will get them more money. And in this case, the dodgy recruiters see you, the candidate, as a potential money-making scheme. That's it. They don't care about you, your interests, your career, or anything like that. They care about you making them money. They would happily place you in as many jobs as possible, even if none of them really align to what you want in your career, solely so they could keep cashing commission checks. To do this, they lie. Blatantly lie. Like a desperately drunk man punching above his weight at the bar trying to pick up attractive ladies, they will lie through their teeth. They'll tell job seekers whatever is likely to get them to accept the job, and they will tell hiring manager whatever is likely to get them to accept the candidate. All they want to do is to convince those two parties to come to an arrangement for at least 3 months so that they get paid and then they're happy. That's not adding value. It's not really, truly caring about what a hiring manager or what a company needs, or about what the individual wants and what their career goal and path is. It's just, can I connect these two people for a short period of time? If so, I will make a lot of money. How do you counter this? Simple. Do your own research. And I've said this in a lot of videos, but ultimately, when you're dealing with someone like a recruiter who is a middleman with a very heavily vested interest, you can't trust everything they say. You need to do your own research, and you are responsible for doing your own research and verifying whatever the recruiter has said. Or one of the ways to do this is don't rely on a single recruiter. If you hear something from a recruiter about a company or the industry being hot or cold or whatever, or certain things are in demand, follow up. Phone 3, 4, 5 other recruiters and ask them the questions. Ask them what they think about the industry. You'll quickly see if there's a pattern, if you're getting valid information, or if they're just fobbing you off with bullshit because they want to place you in whatever role they've got. Other options are you can attend things like meetups where you can talk to other people in the industry who are not specifically recruiters, so they won't have a vested interest in lying to you, and they'll be able to have a more open conversation about where they think the industry is going, what is and isn't working. And you might also meet people in other companies, and you'll get a feel for what a recruiter has said about a company versus what actual people working there are saying about the company. And finally, like if a recruiter has a specific role that they're telling you about or a specific company, research that company. You know, there's websites like Glassdoor, which, you know, they're good and bad in some respects, but you'll find enough information just from searching that will let give you a feel if the recruiter is telling you the truth. It's up to you to keep your finger on the pulse and not rely on the recruiters to do it for you. Other things you can do, set up job alerts so you'll see what the trends are in the industry, what jobs are coming through often. Read relevant articles, blogs, and listen to podcasts. And obviously watch great content on YouTube like this, which, as a reminder, you should totally subscribe to my videos. But whatever it is, get involved in your industry and pay attention yourself. You've got to take responsibility for your career and your knowledge of your industry and what's going on. Don't rely on someone else to give you secondhand information. You should be doing the research and actively engaging so you know what's going on. Think about any other big purchase you would do in your life. Like buying a new car. You don't just walk into a car dealership with no prior research and then start talking to the car salesman and assume that everything they told you was truthful and that that is the absolute best deal you'll ever get. Of course not. You do your research, and you should do your research with your career as well. And you'll quickly learn which recruiters are lying to you. All right, that's it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. If so, please comment below and give me a thumbs up so I can know. And if you are liking these videos, then you should definitely subscribe because every week I'm releasing a new video on dodgy recruiter tactics. So get on the subscription and get on the notifications so that you get the alert for the next video. Otherwise, good luck and have fun. We'll be right back.